Welcome to Cairo Church of God, and starting right on Sunday night, I'm Pastor DeWayne Atkinson. This is a brief devotion and got a word from the Lord, and it is the Christmas season. I wish you a blessed Christmas. Some people have a Merry Christmas and some don't, but I pray for people to have a blessed Christmas and New Year. But before we begin with this, let's pray. Heavenly Father, thank you for starting right on Sunday night, for all the work that goes into it from Brenda Atkinson and Selena Beers. And I pray, God, that you would just bless this broadcast in Jesus' name. Amen. What are you giving people for Christmas, or what do you think you're getting? Well, there's a special or unique class of gifts that I'm going to call two-way Christmas gifts. These are different from the typical gifts that we give or receive, which may be exactly what we want. Hope that it be the case. But actually, there's a different class of gifts and gift giving that we may not realize. And we're going to base this on the verse in Matthew 2:11, where these wise men or magi, they find where Jesus is, and they're going into this house, which appears to be maybe 2 years after Jesus was born. They use poetic license to put the wise men and all of the different people there, shepherds, all at once in the manger scene. But probably that might not have been exactly how it is, but I still like it. I'm used to it, and I think it's nice for it to be portrayed that way. In Matthew 2:11, the Bible says, "And when they," that is these wise men or magi, "were coming to the house, they saw the young child with Mary his mother and fell down and worshiped him. And when they had opened their treasure, they presented unto him gifts, gold, frankincense, and myrrh." One other verse in Galatians 6:9, "And let us not be weary in well-doing, for in due season we shall reap if we faint not." And the Bible does talk about that we reap what we sow as well. Well, some Christmas gifts that we're going to refer to are two-way Christmas gifts. These are wonderful gifts to give, but they have a unique quality because the people who give them also receive them. And it actually, when you give these gifts, you receive them as well. And they bless both the person who is receiving the gift as well as the person who is giving the gift. And it's a direct blessing. Well, let's look at what are some Christmas gifts that are two-way Christmas gifts that probably all of us need to give this Christmas? First of all, there's the gift of forgiveness. Hard to really celebrate Christmas with unforgiveness or bitterness in our heart. We can talk about the joy of the Lord. We can preach about it, sing about it, talk about it, decorate it up. But if there's unforgiveness there, it's going to take the edge off the joy. It's just going to weigh you down. And those who won't forgive, I remember reading a little placard in the first printing place that I worked in, which was the Douglas Enterprise in the 70s. 1970s, and or maybe even in the 60s. But there was a little placard on the second floor where I worked, melting lead down to use for the next week's newspaper or job printing. But there was a little placard there that somebody had put up, and when I would get to the top of the stairs, you would see it every time. And it said something like, "Those who won't forgive, they burn or destroy the bridge over which they themselves must cross." I think that's correct. Well, when you think about forgiveness or unforgiveness, it is like a disease that spreads. It affects everything that you do and everything that you are, or me, or whoever it is. It is like a heavy weight where these people who do training for marathons or other things, they will put extra weights around their ankles or their wrists, and they will wear these weights so they can build up stamina. And when they take those weights off, it's like they suddenly are lighter than air. Well, unforgiveness, it will just weigh you down that way. And not only that, unforgiveness is a thief. It steals. Jesus said of the devil that he just comes to steal, kill, and destroy. Well, that's what unforgiveness does. It's a thief. It steals your joy. You know, when sometimes you may overlook it, hide it, and tuck it away, but when you're all by yourself sometimes, we all then have to deal with ourselves and the weight of our unforgiveness. Not only that, it dims our vision so that we cannot see God's will for our lives or what's best for us. And it comes with a warning. Jesus said people who won't forgive are not going to be forgiven by God. So you need to give forgiveness. Not only that, this is the season, but it should be all year round, where we extend grace or mercy to other people who sometimes don't deserve it. They're like us. This grace is received for four purposes. But we've all sinned and fallen short of the glory of God, according to the book of Romans. And none of us are perfect. And the only way we can be saved from our sins is by the grace of God through faith in Jesus Christ. That's like Ephesians 2, 8, 9. And it is the way and the only way to a relationship with God, and it's through faith in Christ. It shows a world that is lost and dying in their sins what the goodness of God is like when you extend grace to them when they might not deserve it, or you don't think they deserve it. They may deserve it, and you and I may just misjudge. And we need to be careful about judging people before we've walked a mile in their shoes. And the next thing, that's a two-way gift. When you give grace, you receive it. And then when we talk about the power of prayer, when you give prayer, what you're really giving is your time and your energy and your effort. And you have to do that. And somebody said it like this when I first got saved. I heard it a lot, that others need the prayer and believers need the practice. So it doesn't matter who you are, you need prayer. And sometimes we may not have a lot that we could give. Some people have more or much, or sometimes an enormous abundance, but some are very poor. And we may not think we can give anything very important, but you can give prayer. You can talk to God and lift up hurting people to the Lord. And all of these gifts are important. There are many more than that. But we can think about, you could give that forgiveness this Christmas. I hope you will. Get out from under that burden. Don't let it weigh you down all the time for your whole life. Let it go. And what a better time to let it go than at Christmas. To forgive people, you just have to extend grace to them. Well, you can do that because God has extended grace to you. If we all got what we deserve, we'd all end up in hell without any hope. But it's just because of the grace of God that we have a hope in eternity through faith in Christ. And then we all can pray. And I hope that you will. This Christmas season and all year round, keep Christmas in your heart. Give forgiveness and give grace or mercy. Give it away to somebody, or several somebodies, and then give away your time in prayer. The good thing about these two-way gifts is they last for eternity. Some gifts don't even last hardly till you get the box open. And even if the gifts that you give, you may not think these last for eternity, but the blessings from them will last for eternity. And it might make a difference in somebody's future in eternity. Good reason to give them. Good reason to receive them. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, thank you for everyone who's watching. We pray your blessing upon them. And Lord, as we go through this Christmas season, everybody's not going to have a Merry Christmas, their circumstances, their situation. For some people, it's going to be the worst Christmas they've ever had, lost of loved ones, a number of factors. But yet, we all can have a blessed Christmas. And I pray that you would help us to have a blessed Christmas and New Year in Jesus' name. Amen. Well, God bless you. Thank you for watching. I'm Pastor DeWayne Atkinson of Cairo, Georgia, and Pastor of Cairo Church of God. And we're here Sunday mornings at 11, Sunday evenings at 6 p.m., Wednesday nights at 7 p.m. Have a blessed rest of the week and Christmas season.
Oh,